When did you realize the transition to acting was something you could really do?
Well, I think it's when I started doing it. Like, I really loved when I was a model, like creating a character, creating a world, and I was drawn to film anyway, just throughout my life. Like, I just loved watching movies, and it just kind of, like, once I decided to do it, I was like, I'm going to just put 110% into learning and growing, and yeah, because it's a craft, it's a, you know, something that you do. I think for me, I'll always be learning, you know, on every project. So that's what it's felt like. It's felt like kind of learning to crawl, then, you know, learning to stand, learning to walk. So it's been, you know, just persistence of having faith in the people that you work with and being kind of carried with that.
Some actors sneak into the cinema to see how the audience is reacting to the movie. Is that something you would do?
I've seen it twice with an audience when we had you know, cast and crew screening, which was really, really great. And then and the London Film Festival, I watched it because I was with my family and stuff. And yeah, it's nice. It's nice to watch it with people that you love and, you know, get their reaction.
When you were filming, you didn't see the actual effects the viewer sees on the screen, and that shows us how Lily is feeling. How did you prepare to make it come across authentically?
Well, I had the book with Ray Robinson, who wrote the book, and so, you know, that he really, really gets into the first person of what it's really, really like with hallucinations and things. So, and I'd, you know, spoken to people with epilepsy and had their, how they perceive it and what happens, like, on a sensorial level. So I had that to kind of imagine, and then obviously Bryn, the script, and like what Bryn envisaged for it, so I kind of knew what was going to be there, like, afterwards. But I've been blessed, you know, to work with so many great people who I've learned and grown from, you know in electricity, you know, working with Paul and Christian, and you know, everyone in it was so supportive, and it was just a real laugh, you know, it was a big family vibe. So yeah, it's been brilliant.
What was most challenging for you during filming?
The most challenging thing, I suppose, it was very physical. So that was one part that was challenging. And I think also the fact of it was, I didn't really like have my attention on it when I was doing it, but it was obviously being in every single scene, and we weren't shooting it in order of, like, because of locations and things like that. So kind of having to obviously plan everything out so it flowed and things like that.
What is special about Lily apart from having the illness?
She's a fighter, she's creative, she sees the world in this different way, this different reality. You know, it's really, like, for me, I love watching women in film that have to overcome something, that, and that's inspiring to me, so that's what I saw in Lily. You know, she has that motto, thrash, get up, get on with it. And I think that it's just kind of like, you know, fight on for what you need and you want, and yeah, so I think that, and just get up and brush yourself off onto the next thing.
You started working at a really young age. How did that affect your career?
I've always really worked. Like, from the age of 13, my parents, you know, said if you want to buy things or you need things, that you get a job and you earn the money and you can buy them. So I think having that work ethic instilled in a young age, I just really find this joy for working and being independent.
Do you think there are other mothers who should go into acting?
I just think in general, like, people should just do what they want to do. You know, my mum always said, you know, always do a job that you really enjoy doing, and then you'll love to work.
Can you tell us a bit more about the Sunset Song, the latest film you were doing?
Yeah, it's set in 1910, and it's about a young woman called Chris Guthrie, and she is the daughter of a farmer in Aberdeenshire in on this very harsh landscape. And it's about her manoeuvring this masculine world and kind of finding peace with the land and how that affects the people and just being a very strong woman, you know. I feel like it's, it feels like an evolution of Lily, like how Lily at the end of the film is stood on the beach and she's, you know, has taken possession of herself and is at peace. I feel like that's what Chris is like right at the beginning. Mm-hmm. And then she, you know, carries on with this like strong feminine spirit to evolve from there. So it was a really nice process to, you know, play Lily and then play Chris, because it felt like kind of the same spirit.
So how's it being back in the UK?
Fantastic. I love it. I miss it. You know, it's where I'm from, and as soon as I get here, I transport like back into being with friends and family. So
thank you.
Cool. Thank you.